Good afternoon to everybody. So we are at the discussion of electrostatic voltmeters. In previous class, we have discussed about the operating principle, introduction, and the classification of various types of electrostatic instruments in previous classes. So in today's class, we are going to see about extension of range in electrostatic instruments and numerical problems related to the torque equation, which we derived in our previous class. So extension of range. So we discussed about the extension of range in PMMs instruments and in MI instruments. Now we are going to discuss the extension of range in electrostatic instruments. So we already discussed that electrostatic instrument is quite different from previous equipments, right? PMMs and MI. Why? Because electrostatic instrument is quietly operable with respect to the electrostatic effect. It is also called as an electric effect, because of the charge stored in between two parallel plates. Okay, but in PMMC instruments, these are operated with respect to the magnetic effect. Okay, so in this type of a peculiar application of electrostatic meters, so how can we extend the range? How can we extend the range, or how can we increase the range? Means only the thing is in by the application of multipliers. That means if we use an external resistance, if we add an external resistance to the existing meter, that will act like a multiplier. That resistance which we are adding externally, that is called as a multiplier. Only because of the usage of external devices or external resistances, by adding only multiplier, we can increase the range. But how can we increase the, what is the purpose of improving the range? Means if we improve the range of a particular meter, either it is a PMMs instrument or it is an MI instrument, or it is an electrostatic instrument. So if we improve the range of the device, what will happen means the scale medium, that means the particular voltmeter or particular ammeter, if the range is improved, means the current measuring capability or voltage measuring capability will be improved after extending the range of a particular meter, either it is an voltmeter or ammeter, or it is an MI classification or PMMC classification or electrostatic classification. If we extend the range of a meter, okay, the current measuring capability or voltage measuring capability will be improved. So coming into this particular classification, in an electrostatic voltmeter, what is the main advantage of electrostatic voltmeter is, so it can measure a high amount of high voltages, either it may be 10 kV up to 20 kV. We discussed that up to 20 kV instant, we can measure the voltage. Peculiarly, electrostatic voltmeter is operated in DC and as well as AC, which we discussed in previous class, but it is operated with respect to, you know, it is operated depending upon the measurement of voltage. Mostly electrostatic instruments are designed with respect to voltmeters. That means the electrostatic voltmeter main purpose is to measure voltage at an higher magnitude, high voltage magnitude it will measure. So if we see the classification, there are two classifications are there under the extension of range. One is resistance potential divider and second one is a capacitance potential divider. So that means application of multiplier, addition of multiplier. Multiplier is, what is meant by multiplier? Multiplier is nothing but an external resistance which you are adding. So with the application of external resistance in the concept of resistance potential multiplier, what we can do means we can improve the range by increasing the range with respect to DC magnitudes and AC magnitudes. But capacitance potential divider is quite oftenly used only with respect to alternating voltages. So if we see the first classification, that is extension of range with respect to resistance potential multiplier, okay, or resistance potential divider. So what we are going to do in this particular resistance potential divider, okay, so that this part of our concept, that is range extension in electrostatic voltmeters under the classification of resistance potential divider, what we are doing means we are using a non-inductive resistance. A non-inductive resistance is used here. A non-inductive resistance is attached to the electrostatic voltmeter. The main purpose is to increase the magnitude of the existing voltmeter, increase the steady magnitude of existing voltmeter for DC voltages as well as for AC voltages, for DC as well as for AC. What we are doing here, we are using a an external multiplier. We are adding an external multiplier. That external multiplier is nothing but an non-inductive resistance, high non-inductive resistance, which is attached to the existing voltmeter. Okay. So if we say the rating of the particular voltmeter, so capital R is nothing but, let us assume capital R is nothing but the resistance of the total potential difference, which is nothing but our multiplier. So here potential divider is nothing but a multiplier which you are incorporating. Don't get yourself confused. Potential divider is nothing but our multiplier which we are incorporating. Okay. So this potential divider or multiplier or resistance, these are all working synonyms. So this resistance is nothing but a potential divider which is applied across the voltage capital V which we are going to measure. Okay. So small r is nothing but resistance of the potential divider, resistance of the potential divider which you are going to add. So if we see the multiplication factor, if we just see the multiplication factor, just go through the multiplication factor. Multiplication factor will be capital V divided by small v, that is equal to capital R divided by small r. That means here initial voltage is small v and change in voltage, initial voltage is capital V, change in voltage is represented with respect to small v. The potential divider resistance is, the whole amount of potential divider resistance is represented with capital R, but a part of the resistance is represented with respect to smaller. Part of resistance is represented with respect to smaller. So if we see the entire perspective in a big picture, so how we are using the resistance potential divider means, so this is the resistance potential divider application. Okay, a non-inductive resistance. See, this is nothing but the non-inductive resistance. Non-inductive resistance is connected. This is nothing but the non-inductive resistance. A non-inductive resistance is connected across to the voltage which we are going to measure. Across the voltage which we are going to measure. Okay. And this is nothing but our electrostatic voltmeter. Electrostatic voltmeter. This is capital V is nothing but voltage under measurement. Small v is nothing but voltage measured. Capital V is nothing but voltage under measurement. Small v is nothing but voltage what we measured. Okay. So we incorporated, what we did means we added a potential divider. Potential divider, total resistance of the potential divider is represented with capital R, and a small amount of potential divider is the parallel resistance of potential divider is represented with respect to smaller. That means here if we add a particular potential divider type of non-inductive resistance to the existing electrostatic voltmeter, what will happen means the range of the electrostatic voltmeter is improved. The range of electrostatic voltmeter is improved. How the range of the electrostatic voltmeter is improved means the range of the electrostatic voltmeter is improved because of addition of an potential divider. That means already exist out on electrostatic voltmeter ki manam additional ga oka resistance add chesamandi. Resistance add chesthe em avutundandi, when an existing circuit is added with an external resistance, this is nothing but an external resistance, or this is nothing but the potential divider which we are talking about, this is nothing but a multiplier which we are discussing, which we are thinking. So if we add this type of a resistance to an existing meter, what will happen? The current carrying capability will be limited and the voltage carrying capability will be improved. That is the main concept with respect to the electrical circuits. If we add an external potential divider to the existing circuit, current will be limited and voltage handling capability of the circuit will be improved. That means the calibrated scale of the electrostatic voltmeter is improved by adding an external potential divider. That is what happening here. So that is about the concept, that is electrostatic voltmeter extension range under the application of resistance potential divider. This is a non-inductive resistance or non-inductive potential divider or non-inductive multiplier, whatever it may be the literature term. So coming to the second classification of extension range, that is capacitance potential divider. So this is a different aspect. This is a different aspect from resistance potential divider. So what we are doing here means, in this concept of capacitance potential divider, we are doing a different thing here. One second. So under this concept of capacitive potential divider, what we are doing at this instant of capacitive potential divider, with respect to the previous discussion, we have added an additional capacitance. That is, this is nothing but electrostatic voltmeter. Electrostatic voltmeter is represented with respect to C suffix V. We have added an additional capacitor in series to the existing electrostatic voltmeter. If we add an additional capacitor to the existing electrostatic voltmeter with respect to the capacitance effect, what is the capacitance effect? Capacitor will charge for an instant of time, and later the time capacitor will discharge. So depending upon this instant, this is how we connect a capacitance potential bridge. So this is the series of capacitors are added. A series of capacitors are added one after another to this particular electrostatic voltmeter. This is nothing but our electrostatic voltmeter. With respect to the electrostatic voltmeter, we are adding a series of capacitances. A series of capacitances are added. After joining all these series of capacitors together, as in the structure of to form together a potential divider, okay, what will happen? The voltage carrying capability of this particular electrostatic voltmeter is improved. Okay, the voltage carrying capability, that's what we are talking, extension of range of electrostatic voltmeter under the classification of capacitance potential divider is improved by connecting a number of capacitances in series together. After connecting a number of capacitors series together across to the electrostatic voltmeter, will increase the voltage carrying capability, and extension of a range will be improved. So that is about the two classifications. So if we see the theoretical perspective, this is the theoretical perspective. If we see the mathematical analysis, so we already discussed about the multiplication factor. So if we see the mathematical analysis with respect to the multiplication factor, which we are talking about, the multiplication factor is represented with respect to capital V divided by small v, that is equal to resistance of total circuit with respect to the resistance of voltmeter. That means the resistance of the total circuit, or the voltage carrying capability, or voltage to be measured is represented with capital V, whereas voltage which is measured by the electrostatic voltmeter is represented with respect to small v. Okay, so if we use this type of multiplication factor, and if we observe the capacitance rating of total circuit, what will be the capacitance rating of total circuit? Capacitance of the total circuit, that is equal to C into C suffix V, and capacitance of the existing voltmeter, that is C plus CV. That means initial capacitance of the voltmeter is C suffix V, and the added capacitor is capital C. So if we see the reactance, that is equal to 1 by omega into capacitance, that is equal to C plus CV divided by omega into C into CV. Okay, if we substitute that in the form of a reactance, so what will be the total existence of the, what will be the total reactance of the voltmeter? The total reactance of the voltmeter, that is equal to 1 by omega into CV. Okay, if we substitute the both of terms, that is capital V, but if we substitute the multiplication factor, that is capital V divided by small v, that is equal to, okay, so this is one reactance parameter, that is C plus CV divided by omega into CV divided by 1 by omega C. 1 by omega C is nothing but the reactance of the voltmeter. So if we substitute this parameter, and if we calculate from this expression, what will be the new expression? New expression will be capital C plus CV divided by C. Okay, so this will be the new multiplication factor. What is the new multiplication factor? New multiplication factor, that is capital V divided by small v, that is equal to total capacitance of the circuit plus capacitance of the voltmeter divided by total capacitance, that is equal to 1 plus CV divided by this C. So what is the new multiplication factor? New multiplication factor is equal to voltage which is to be measured, that is capital V, divided by voltage to be measured by the voltmeter small v, that is equal to 1 plus voltage of the capacitance voltage with respect to total capacitance of the circuit. So this is nothing but the existing multiplication factor for a capacitance potential divider voltmeter, capacitance potential divider equipment. I hope it's clear. If you have any doubts, just let me know in the chat. Let me know in the chat. So next we are going to discuss about next we are going to discuss about problems. The first problem, make yourself comfortable with your calculator. Okay, solve along with me. I will analyze the problem with step by step. So I will solve parallel along with you. Okay, so make yourself comfortable. I already shared the calculator link in the Play Store. Okay, Play Store calculator application is shared in the WhatsApp group. Just go through that link and download the scientific calculator if you don't have a scientific calculator. Otherwise, if you are available with scientific calculator, just use it and answer to my question. So we will solve in steps one by one. First question, that is an absolute electrostatic voltmeter. It is an absolute instrument. Uses an movable circular plate. Okay, this is the second classification of electrostatic instruments. Electrostatic instruments are mostly classified with two types. One is linear type. Okay, linear motion type electrostatic instrument, which uses two electrodes. And second type that is circular motion type or circular plate type. So this is the second classification, circular plate type, 8 mm in diameter. Circular plates are having a diameter of 8 mm. And during the voltage measurement, the distance between two plates, that is one is circular motion plate, is circular type electrostatic voltmeter will have two plates. One is fixed plate and which is pivoted together to the jewel. And second one is moving plate, which is connected to the spindle. Okay, the distance between fixed plate and moving plate, that is 3.2 mm. Okay, in the distance between two plates, one is fixed plate, another one is moving plate, the distance is around 3.2 mm. The force of attraction, that is 0.003 Newton. The force is already given. And he already described the air gap. The air gap permittivity, that is epsilon naught, that is equal to 8.85 into 10 to the power of minus 12 farad per meter, force per meters. So we need to determine capital V. We need to determine capital V. We have force, we have distance between the plates, we have diameter of the plate, and we have the air permittivity. We have to determine the voltage. So this is about the given data we got. Okay. So the actual area, that is equal to this is a circular plate. This is a circular plate. That's why represented with respect to pi by 4, area of circle, pi by 4 into area of circle, that is about pi by 4 into 0.02 whole square. So this is the area. One second. This is the area of circle we got. This is the area. And the diameter is represented with respect to the meter, 0.0032 meters. And force is represented with respect to Newton, that is F is equal to 0.03 Newton. And permittivity is represented here. So if we have to find out the voltage expression, what is the formula? Voltage, actual voltage, that is equal to V is equal to square root of 2 FD square by epsilon A. From the torque expression, we derived this. Already we discussed in the previous classes with respect to voltage expressions and current expressions. So capital V is equal to square root of 2 FD square divided by epsilon into A. So substitute the parameters one by one. Substitute the parameters one by one, that is equal to capital V is equal to, solve along with me and use the scientific calculator and answer me the answers. 2 into, what is the value of F? F is equal to 0.0032 into, what is the value of D? D is equal to 3.2 whole square. The total value is divided by, the total value is divided with respect to epsilon into A. What is the value of epsilon here? Epsilon is not epsilon. What is the value of epsilon in the given data? Epsilon is equal to 8.85. into 10 to the power minus 12. 0.85 into 10 to the power minus 12. 10 to the power of minus 12 into 10 to the power of minus 12 into what is the value of A? We got the value of A, that is 5.0265 into 10 to the power minus 3. 10 to the power minus 3. What is the answer we got? Just anybody respond in the chat. Are you following the procedure? Anybody is having any doubt? Just let me know what will be the answer. Did somebody posted an answer in the chat? What is it? Let me check. Eleven seventy-five volts. Is a similar answer you got, most of your people? Let me check the procedure. Yes, 1175 volts. Is it correct? Can I go to next problem? Is the answer tallied with? Only a few people responded, only around 1175 volts. Okay, 1175. Right. Most of the people got similar answer, right? Is it clear with this question? Can I go to the next problem? Right, okay. Thank you. Right. Second problem. So in the second problem, 1175 volts, right? 236, right? Your answer is correct. I'm going to the second problem. Right, 1175 volts. So this is the second problem. I will forward the presentation to the WhatsApp group. Don't get yourself deviated. Just solve along with me. Okay. So this is the second problem. So in this electrostatic instrument, this is a moving plate. This is an electrostatic instrument. We are having fixed plate and moving plate. We haven't described the classification. Either it is an linear type or rotating type. You just described about fixed plate and moving plate. The moving plate diameter is around 110 volts. Okay. When 12 kV is applied in between two plates, fixed plate and moving plates, the force created in between fixed plate and moving plate, that is 0.006 newton. Find the change in capacitance for 1.2 mm movement in the moving plate. Okay. So that is a given data. That is a given data we got. So the diameter of the moving plate is 110 mm, that is 0.01 meter, and the voltage applied, that is V is equal to 1.12 kV, and force, that is around 0.006 observed at moving plate, and we are adding, there is a change in capacitance. The problem itself stating there is a change in capacitance. So what will happen? What is the change in the behavior of electrostatic voltmeter? That's they are asking. So let us see. So we are all familiar with the force expression. F is equal to half V square DC divided by DX. If we substitute the values in the one by one in parameters, that is force F is equal to 0.06 into, that is equal to 1.2 into V square. That what is the value of V? 12 kV. That is 12 into 10 to the power of minus 3 whole square into DC divided by DX. So we have to find out the change in voltage. Then there is a change in voltage at 1.2 mm. What is the value of change in voltage DC divided by DX? Okay, solve that thing. What is the value of the change in capacitance, that is DC divided by DX? solve an answer to me in the chat. I will check out the chat one by one. DC divided by DX ento ostundo cheppandi. Next, after calculating the change in capacitance with respect to change in capacitance DC divided by DX, we will observe how much amount of capacitance is changed with respect to the movement of the moving plate when we are applying with the 1.2 mm. Okay, what is the value of DC divided by DX? Right, someone posted in the chat. DC divided by DX, that is equal to 83.33 into 10 to the power of minus 12. The units is force per meter. Is the same thing we got? Right, did anybody tally the answer? Only few people responded. Only three people responded with respect to the solution. 83.33 into 10 to the power of minus 6, minus 12, right? The units are force per meter, right? Around 6 to 7 people got the similar answer. So this is nothing but change in capacitance. This is nothing but change in capacitance per meter. So change in capacitance, that is 83.3 to 10 to the power of minus 12 force per meter. So here we said for 1.2 mm. So if we calculate the same thing for 1.2 mm, that is equal to change in capacitance, that is DC. DC is nothing but change in capacitance. That is equal to 83.33 into 10 to the power of minus 12 into 1.2 into 10 to the power of minus 3. 1.2 mm that is converted into meters. That is 1.2 10 to the power of minus 3. That is around 0.1 picofarad. Okay. Is it clear with this problem? Or anybody is having any doubt? Or anybody is having any misconception answers? Just anybody respond in the chat. Can I go to the second problem? Can I go to the second problem? Sorry, third problem. Is it clear? Thank you. Right. This problem number three. The problem number three stated that electrostatic voltmeter has a full scale deflection of 90 degrees. 90 degrees is the full scale deflection. And the control constant of spring constant is having control constant, that is 8.8 into 10 to the power of minus 6 Newton meter per radian. When the reading is zero, that means when the needle is at zeroth position, the capacitance is at 12 picofarad. 12 picofarad. What is the capacitance when the instrument reads 1500 volts and at a deflection of 90 degrees? Just go through the problem once. So he said there is an initial deflection. Initial deflection is 90 degrees. The initial deflection is around 90 degrees and later there is a change in deflection. So we will see that. So if we see the given data. So this is a given data. Theta is equal to 90 degrees, that is pi by 2 radians. And we had a spring constant, that is 8 into 10 to the power of minus 6 Newton meter per radian. Okay. Is it clear? And capacitance, change in capacitance, initial capacitance is 12 picofarad when the reading is zero. Okay. And the voltmeter reads around 1.5 kV, that is 1500 volts. 1500 volts. Meter reads around 1500 volts. So we need to find out the full scale, the behavior at full scale deflection, that is when deflection torque is equal to controlling torque at a steady state deflection. That means after the instrument reaching a particular instant of 90 degrees, full scale deflection. At an equilibrium state or at steady state deflection, deflection torque is equal to controlling torque, that is equal to half v square dc divided by d theta. We know the expression, we calculated in previous classes. And controlling torque, that is t suffix c, is equal to k into theta. So from that expression, if we substitute the values, that is dc divided by d theta, that is equal to 2k theta divided by v square. What is the value of spring constant? spring constant is equal to 8 into 10 to the power minus 6 into pi by into theta, that is pi by 2. What is the behavior of voltage? That is 1500 volts, that is whole square. What is the value of DC divided by d theta? Answer to this question. What is the value of DC divided by d theta? Did anybody respond in the chat? I am checking the chat. Solve along with me. It will be simple. Otherwise, it will make the things quite complex. Okay. What is the answer? Right. Let me check. 0.11 into 10 to the power of minus 19. 0.11 into 10 to the power of minus 19. Right. Only 2 to 3 people responded. Anybody got the same answers? 0.11 into 10 to the power of minus 1 farad per radian. Right. 1.11 into 10 to the power of minus 11. That is also correct. 212. Right. Correct. It's correct. Okay. Let me check. At 0.11 to 10 to the power minus 1 farad per radian. So that is about change in capacitance. If we find out change in capacitance, that is D suffix DC, that is equal to change in capacitance is equal to 0.11 into 10 to the power of minus 10 into pi by 2. That is equal to 0.11 into 10 to the power of minus 10 farad. Right. So 281, right? Correct. It's correct. 2017, it's correct. Okay. So the new value of capacitance, that is 12 into 10 to the power of minus 12. So if we substitute this entire value in new value of 12 picofarad, change in capacitance, it is 0.17 into 10 to the power of minus 10 per farad. Per 12 picofarad, that is 12 into 10 to the power of minus 12 plus, if we add this thing, this is the new parameter, that is 29 picofarad we got. Okay, is this problem clear? Can I go to the next problem? Can I go to the next problem? Is it clear? Or anybody is having a doubt? If you have any doubt with the problem calculation, then let me know in the chat. Okay. Thank you. Thank you, everyone. Thank you to 81. So if you go to the next problem. So the electrostatic voltmeter is reading up to 2000 volts. Okay, and it is controlled by a control spring with a torsion constant of 5 into 10 to the power of minus 6 Newton meter per radian. That is a spring constant, 5 into 10 to the power of minus 6. And we are having a full scale deflection theta, that is equal to 90 degrees. Okay, the capacitance at zero voltage is at 15 picofarad. So what is the capacitance when the pointer indicates 2000 volts? So we need to find out the capacitance when the pointer indicates 2000 volts. So if we see this thing, if we solve the parameter, if we solve this type of problem, so this is a 2015 gate model. In gate exams, we got this problem. This type of models are most frequently occurred in competitive exams. So if we solve this problem, let us see the given data. Okay. So the deflection theta is 90 degrees, that is pi by 2. And we know from the particular torque equation, if we equalize the deflection torque with respect to controlling torque, if we add the steady state deflection, T suffix D is equal to T suffix C. After T suffix D is equal to T suffix C, we know that what is the value of T suffix D is equal to half V square into DC divided by D theta, that is equal to spring control constant, that is K into theta. So from this, if we equalize the parameter, that is theta is equal to half V square divided by K into DC divided by D theta. Okay. So if we substitute the values, what is the value of V? V is around 2000 volts. If we substitute the values, okay, what is the value of DC divided by D theta? That is 2 theta into K divided by V square, that is 2 into pi by 2 into 5 to 10 power minus 6 divided by 2000 square. Okay. So if we substitute this value, what is the value of DC divided by D theta? Let me analyze in the chat. What is your answer in the chat? What is the value of DC divided by D theta? Simple, just calculate this term, we will get change in capacitance. That's what he asked. He asked us to find out change in capacitance. Change in capacitance if the pointer indicates 2000 volts. So we need to find out DC divided by D theta. What is the value we got? The answer, most of the people, only two people quoted, that is 3.93 into 10 to the power of 12 farad per radian. 3.93 into 10 to the power of minus 12. 212, 281. Only two people quoted. Right, farad per radian, correct. Okay. But anybody got, anybody just verify this thing? 212 and 281 got the similar answers. 3.92 into 10 to the power of minus 12. Right, someone posted 3.93 picofarad per radian. It is also correct. 3.93 picofarad per radian. It is also correct. Okay. Right. So let me verify. The answer is around 3.93 into 10 to the power of 12 picofarad per radian, or it is 3.93 into 3.93 picofarad per rad. Okay. So if we, is it clear with this problem? Can I go to the next problem? If anybody is having any problem, any doubt with this problem, just let me know in the chat. So this is a change in capacitance. Initial capacitance we calculated. Later, this is a change in capacitance with respect to change in deflection. That is 3.93 into pi by 2. That is 6.17 picofarad. And the capacitance after reading 2000 volts, that is around 15 plus, that is 15 picofarad plus 6.17, that is 21.17 picofarad. That's what we calculated the things here. So if we go into the next problem, so an absolute electrostatic meter has a moving circular plate. This is the second classification, that is 80 mm diameter. Okay. And the distance between the plate, that is 4 mm. Okay. So if we find the potential difference when the force of attraction is around 2 into 10 to the power of minus 3 Newton. Okay. The dielectric permittivity of air is around 8.85 into 10 to the power of minus 3. Okay. So if we solve this thing, the distance between the plates, that is 4 mm. That is 4 mm into 10 power minus 3, and the area of plates, that is a circular plate, that is pi by 4 d square. Area of circle, that is pi by 4 d square, that is pi by 4 into d, that is diameter of the circular plate, that is 80 into 10 power of minus 3 whole square. So if we solve that, this is the thing. Area of the plates, that is 5.026 into 10 power of minus 3 meter square. So if we find out the value of voltage, capital V is equal to square root of 2fb square by epsilon a. If we substitute the values here, what will be the parameter? Capital V is equal to square root of, capital V is equal to square root of 2 into, what is the value of F? We got force of attraction, that is 2 into 10 to the power minus 3. Minus 3 into d. What is the value of d again? D is around 80 into 10 to the power minus 3 whole square. The whole value is divided with respect to epsilon into a. What is the value of epsilon? Value of epsilon is not, epsilon is 8.85 into 10 to the power minus 3. 10 to the power of minus 3 into, what is the value of capital A? The value of capital A, that is capital A that is 5.026 into 10 to the power minus 3. What is the answer now? Calculate this thing and post your answer in the chat. Right, it's correct. Not 80, that is That is 4 into 10 to the power of minus 3. I got the wrong conception here. Okay. But someone posted in the chat. Thank you. Did anyone respond in the chat? What will be the answer? If we solve this expression, did someone posted 1200 volts? Only two, three people responded 1200 volts. Anybody got the same answer, 1200 volts? Right, okay. The answer is around 1200 volts. Is it correct? 1200 volts, 271 got 1200 volts. Any people, only 4 or 5 people got this thing. This is one important model. Just solve this thing, the answer is 1200 volts. Answer is 1200 volts. So is it clear with this problem? I'm going to the next problem. So this is a different model asked in staff selection committee 2018 model. This is one of the important model. That is a moving vane of a quadrant electrometer turned through 25 scale divisions when ideostatically connected to potential difference of 60 volts. When used heterostatically with the quadrants connected to a small amount of voltage, the meter needs 900 volts. The deflection is 10 scales per deflection. Calculate the value of capital B. So if you see the data, the deflection with ideostatic voltmeter, that is, we have calculated the quadrant volt electrostatic voltmeter into two types, that is, quadrant electrometer, that is, heterostatic quadrant voltmeter and idiostatic quadrant voltmeter, or ideostatic quadrant voltmeter, that is theta is equal to epsilon r square divided by d into v square. This is for one coil classification. This is for additional classification. Just note this thing. If we solve the problem from this, capital V is nothing but voltage to be measured and small v1 is nothing but voltage of the needle. If we substitute the values, so what will be the given answer? Answer is around 0.8 volts. 0.8 volts. This is a different problem. Just go through this type of problems. I will forward that in the tutorial sheet. But thank you, everyone. Thank you for your time.